Roderick Justin Rod Ferrell, born March 28, 1980, is an American murderer and cult leader. He was part of a teenage gang from Murray, Kentucky, known as the Vampire Clan. Ferrell claimed to be a 500 years old vampire named Visago, a character he created for himself. After becoming obsessed with the role-playing game Vampire the Masquerade, Rod was first introduced to this game by his mother, Sandra Gibson. In 1998, Ferrell pleaded guilty to the double murder of a couple in Estes, becoming the youngest person in the United States on death row. Originally sentenced to death, Ferrell's sentence has since been reduced to life without parole.
It all started in the small town of Murray in Kentucky, where Ferrell grew up. A small group of young people gather, fascinated by vampires and the occult. They hang out in the streets, and the group calls themselves the Vampire Clan. Rod Ferrell is Sandra's son, Joan Gibson, and Rick Alan Ferrell. Sandra was 17 when she became a mother. Rod's parents married right after he was born, but divorced less than a year later. Rod. Rick wanted to start a military career, but won't really know his father. His mother and maternal grandparents, Ariel and Rosetta Gibson, raised Rod. His very religious grandparents were also what can be called outsiders.
Rod would have confided later that he was raped by grandfather at the age of 5, and that his grandparents were part of the Black Mask sect. No, I'm not talking about Batman, whose members were worshippers of the devil.
His mother did odd jobs and was also an exotic dancer and sometimes prostituted herself. Fascinated by the occult, she introduced her son to paranormal stories but also to tarot. Also fascinated by the vampiric world, it is she who will initiate Rod in this universe. Her mother will become a drug user and the whole family will live mainly on state subsidies. This family context will not allow Ferrell to know where is reality and where is imagination. Family occult belief didn't help Rod to allow him to be rational. As a teenager, Rod hung out with other young people who adopted a vampire lifestyle, and in 1993, while in Florida in Estes, he met Heather Randolph, who was impressed by the dark charisma of the young man and his black dress style, his trench coat and his raven black hair. He went out with a girl named Janine Leclerc. He describes himself as the fallen angel, who was allegedly chosen by the devil to create an infernal army. After being expelled from Dusty's high school, he returns to Murray in Kentucky, where he meets several other teenagers who are also fascinated by the occult. One of them, named Jaden, leader of a vampire group, is said to have taught Rod this lifestyle. The vampire did not condone murder. In 1996, Jaden took Rod to the town's old Salem cemetery to formalize him as a vampire. After Rod slashed his left arm in front of a tree, he gave his blood to drink to Jaden, who did the same afterwards. The clan was just asking for loyalty and dedication to the vampire family. Ferrell claimed to be a 500-year-old vampire named Visago, a character he created for himself after becoming obsessed with the role-playing game Vampire the Masquerade. Rod was first introduced to this game by his mother, Sandra Gibson. Rod's group of friends also loved the game, but one day, a kitten with scratch rolled after he struck it. Excess of rage then seized the rogue, who took the kitten by the neck and threw it strongly against a tree, breaking his spine, killing him, and that in front of Jaden's eyes. Jaden couldn't stand this spectacle, and his friendship with Rod waned. Rod and Jaden left high school at the age of 16, seeing no future at the time. They were content to hang out, play role playing games, etc. After a big argument, Jaden and Rod no longer spoke to each other.
This argument will be the consequence of a scandal affecting Ferrell's mother and Jaden's little brother. Indeed, Sandra get closer to Josh Murphy, 14 years old, brother of Stephen Murphy, alias Jaden. She reportedly sent sexually explicit letters to Josh. Jaden's mother reportedly filed a complaint against Sandra, and the friendship between Rod and Jaden was reportedly broken.
Rod made new friends and used drugs, heroin, cocaine, etc., and other substances, which made him impulsive. After the argument with Jaden, Rod had therefore subsequently created his own group of vampires called the Vampire Clan. This is how the clan was born, made up of Rod Ferrell, Aurel Scott Anderson, who took Rod for reference, Danielle Cooper and Sarah Remington. He kept in touch with Heather and Janine in Florida as well. A fine liar and a very good manipulator, Rod came to have a great hold on the members of his clan. The clan made animals sacrifice, sex, orgy, and hang out at night in cemeteries, and had established their HQ in a ruin near in the hills of the city. Ferrell is said to have even mutilated two puppies in a vampiric ceremony, stolen from an animal shelter, after assaulting several other dogs present. In addition, he supposedly wanted to open the gates of hell and consume souls to gain power. Rod would already have the desire to kill at that moment, but above all, he wanted to go far from Murray and its surroundings, and why not go to New Orleans, a country with a lot of history and occult legends. If the Aunt Zoe Wendorf often called him to complain about her family, to the point that she often asked Rod for help. When Rod, accompanied by his clan, decided to go to the New Orleans, he would have made a big detour to Estes, where Heather lived. After seeing some of his old friends the day before, on November 25, 1996, Naomi Ruth Quinn and Richard Randolph were found by their older daughter, Jennifer Randolph, beaten to death in their home in Estes. Heather was came to her boyfriend to say goodbye before running away with the clan to the New Orleans. So that day, while Richard Randolph, 49, slept on his couch, and Ruth was in the shower, Ferrell and his accomplice, Aurel Scott Anderson, entered the house through the garage and picked up a crowbar. Before Richard even woke up, Ferrell beat him several times, fracturing his skull and ribs, knocking him out almost instantly and killing him soon after. Ferrell allegedly scored a V by burning the skin on the victim's chest with a cigarette. Then it was Ruth's turn.
But Ferrell claimed in his confession that in his original plan, he wanted to allow Naomi Ruth to live. But as she attacked him by pouncing on him and throwing him a hot cup of coffee and scratching him, enraged, he would have changed his mind. So he would have beaten her to death as well.
After taking the money from the house and invalid all the victims, then cutting all the wires from the phone in the house, Ferrell and his accomplice fled in the Randolph's car, but they were arrested in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, with the rest of his clan. Indeed, the clan no longer having any money, Charity called her grandmother. The grandmother will tell her to take shelter in a hotel, but instead of helping her, she will call the police, who will arrest them in the process. Either would not have known, according to her, of the plans to assassinate Ferrell against her parents, and was in shock when she found out what had happened. Ferrell was having fun with the media, sticking his tongue out and laughing. He liked that the spotlight was on him. Howard Scott Anderson was convicted of aiding and abetting murder and sentenced to life in prison, but was changed to 14 in prison. Charity Kills was convicted of 2 counts of third-degree murders, theft with a firearm or lethal weapon, and burglary with a weapon. She was sentenced to 10 years in state prison. Dana Cooper was also convicted of this charge, but was sentenced to 17 years in prison. And as I said at the start of the video, Ferrell initially sentenced to death. Ferrell's sentence has since been reduced to life without parole after he was found to be hopelessly corrupt. Ferrell developed a passion for drawing in prison, and some of his drawings are even on sale. I made a video on the subject. I put the link at the end of the video.
Hope you liked this video. Feel free to subscribe.
Bye bye. See you soon in your nightmare.